on the shores of the Clayborough Harbour, just an hour's ride north of Auckland, New Zealand, is the farm of Alan Gibbs, and it is on this farm that he has established a world-leading sculpture park. Here the rolling landscape provides an excellent location for site-specific sculpture. Since 1991, Alan Gibbs has commissioned an ever-growing number of sculptures from some of the world's greatest contemporary artists.
So you're looking at some very, very major works of art by major international artists. There's no place like it in New Zealand. There are very few places like it in the world. Alan Gibbs, the owner of the park and a long-time art lover, which I'll give you a little potted history of him in a second. He got his inspiration initially from a place called Storm King, which is a sculptural park.
Following the contour and lie of the land, this great minimalist wall is made of 56 great steel plates, each individually shaped and rolled in Germany. Each plate is 50 millimeters thick, 6 meters high, and weighs 11 tons. The whole wall stretches for an awesome 252 meters.
In continual production. In other words, it's still being built today even. Gradually the idea is for all of the features of the park to be built.
This ongoing, ever-growing row of fence posts currently reaches for 3.2 kilometres across the farm.
Another American artist actually called George Reiki. Passed away in the year 2000. And he worked in the Second World War. He was trained as a designer before the Second World War.
Combining his love of engineering and mechanics with his design skills, George Reiki's sculptures are so delicately balanced that they move on just a breath of breeze. Artist's first large work. A construction team at the farm built this by scaling up from a small wire model provided by the artist. American artist Sol Lee Witt is a leading figure in the history of minimalism and conceptualism. He used a total of 900 solid blocks in this construction. Ahead of us on the hilltop can be seen the work of New Zealand artist Neil Dawson. Dawson used the idea of a sheet of farmyard corrugated iron blown and dumped by the wind for this structure.
He's come to New Zealand from Europe, Leon van Dijssel, and he's come from Holland, and actually he's a friend of the
In certain light conditions, the colouring used in this construction enables it to almost disappear against the sky. And there's no mistaking this. It's a Lenlai wind wand. It's a 45 metre high fiberglass rod, only 200 millimetres wide. Here, a vast PVC membrane is stretched between two steel ellipses. The form is derived from the artist's interest in the body's internal organs. The red coloured membrane represents the skin, and I suspect blood. On this walk around the park, we're only able to fit in about half of the exhibits. We have to keep going though, in order to keep to our schedule. But there is more for us to see along our route. This dramatic ridgetop structure has a commanding position, towering over the whole of the sculpture park. Throughout our visit, it's been drawing us like a magnet. These 8 carefully constructed steel arcs echo the curves of the rolling ridges and interwinding gullies. Unseen to the viewer are the hidden foundations of 300 tons of steel on concrete, which are essential to keep the towering sculpture in place. To the highest point of 11.5 meters, this landform sculpture is the largest and most ambitious work to date by American sculptor Maya Lin. Around the park there are a variety of unexpected living creatures. Each being a live, walking, moving art form. Standing on a ridge, Jeff Thompson's giraffe is much taller than the giraffes walking around below. The shy, barely touching forms of tango dancers have been painted with a pearlescent paint which changes colour in different light conditions throughout the day. Our final exhibit of the day is this floating stainless steel island. The artist has created a scaled up representation of his tiny rock model. It's time for us to leave, but there's more to see next time.